Since alcohols are terrible leaving groups, we often want to convert them into alkyl halides. And it turns out that there are two very common reagents that are used to turn alcohols into alkyl halides. So let's go ahead and just look right into those. So basically, these reagents are SOCl2 and PBr3. And respectively, they're going to turn alcohols into alkyl chlorides or alkyl bromides. All right? Now, the only thing that's special about these is that these are always going to proceed through an SN2 mechanism, okay? So what that means is that since it's SN2 backside attack, these are going to be limited to working on only primary and secondary alcohols, okay? So if I have a tertiary alcohol, I cannot use SOCl2 or PBr3 because I'm not going to get a backside attack. Remember that SN2 just means backside attack. And remember that tertiaries suck at it because tertiaries don't have a good backside. So I need it to be either primary or secondary. Since this is a backside attack, what kind of stereochemistry do you think we could expect? We're always going to get inversion of configuration. Okay? Remember that inversion of configuration and backside attack go hand in hand. Anytime I say one, I'm going to always be referring to the other. So let's go ahead and analyze this mechanism, okay? I'm going to show you the general mechanism for SOCl2, but the same thing applies to PBr3. In fact, I'm going to have you guys figure out the mechanism for PBr3 all on your own. Let's go ahead and check out SOCl2. So overall, the structure of SOCl2, or thionyl chloride, is an S, a double bond O, and then two chlorines coming off the ends, okay? What's special about this molecule is that it actually has a very, very electrophilic portion, okay? Think of this oxygen here as a nucleophile. It has extra electrons that it wants to give away. If it were to attack one of the atoms on those four, on this thionyl chloride, Cl, sulfur, oxygen, which one would be the most susceptible towards nucleophilic attack? Or in other words, which one has the biggest partial positive charge that would be attracted to the negative charge of the oxygen? And if you draw dipoles, it becomes painfully clear that you have dipoles pulling in all directions away from the sulfur, okay? So what that means is that the sulfur is gonna have a very significant partial positive charge. So my arrow is gonna start from my oxygen and attack the sulfur, okay? So can I just leave it like that? Are we done with this mechanism, or at least this part? No, because if we make a bond, we have to break a bond, because sulfur cannot have five bonds, okay? It can either have four, or it can expand its octet to have six, but it can't have five. So the bond that we're gonna break is the one, the double bond leading up to the O. So we're gonna kick those electrons up to the O. Let's go ahead and draw the next step. So what I wind up getting is I wind up getting O, H. Okay, that H is still there from before, but now that's attached to a sulfur, an O negative, a chlorine, and a chlorine. Okay? So now in this next step, we're forgetting a charge. There should be a positive charge right there because oxygen doesn't like having three bonds. All right? So now what's the next step? Well, the next step is that this oxygen does not like having that negative formal charge, and it actually has two really good leaving groups right there. So what's going to happen is that this negative charge is going to go down and reform the double bond and kick out one of these chlorines. Okay? So what I'm going to get at this stage is I'm going to wind up getting a leaving group that looks like this. O, S, double bond OCl with the H here and the positive charge. Okay? So it turns out that now this leaving group is awesome because that O has a direct positive charge, which means that after it leaves, it will be neutral, which is great. On top of that, the sulfur pulls electrons away. So this just has an awesome, this is an amazing leaving group. So what do you think could kick it out? What do you think could attack the carbon and kick out this big leaving group? And it's going to be the Cl negative that just got kicked out. This Cl that we kicked out is now this Cl. And what's going to wind up happening is that now we get the backside attack. Now I'm going to get the Cl attacking that carbon and kicking out this entire thing as the leaving group. So what I wind up getting is an alkyl halide. In this case, it's an alkyl chloride, where my chlorine should be facing which direction? It needs to be on the dash. The reason is because notice that my leaving group was on the wedge before. So after I did a backside attack, I need to invert the stereochemistry. I'm going to get that, plus I'm going to get my leaving group, which just looks like this. Cl on one side and OH on the other. But guess what? Your chemistry professor does not really care about this one. I'm just going to put a little X. They don't care about that. What they really care about is your organic product or this guy over here. Especially that you know the stereochemistry, because that lets them know that you really understand what's going on. All right? So I hope that mechanism wasn't too complicated. I know it was a little weird how we kicked the electrons up to the O and kicked out a chlorine, but that's actually a really common pattern when it comes to double bonds to O. And in Orgo 2, we're going to be doing this mechanism all the time. So it's actually really good that you're getting practice with it right away. So that was the mechanism of thionyl chloride. What I want you guys to do now is to use that knowledge to try to draw the mechanism for this entire reaction all on your own. I know that sounds really complicated, but just so you guys know, the PBr3 is going to react exactly the same way as the SOCl2 did. In fact, it's going to be a little bit easier, okay? And then the NaN3 is just a reaction that you should know from before that I'd like you to integrate with this to try to figure out what's going on, okay? So even if you don't get the second part, at least give the first step of this reaction your best shot, and then I'll explain everything to you. So go for it.